Warning, this video may contain graphic content, such as sexual scenes, violence, gore, boobies, and the rest of the fun stuff. Please be over 18 to view this, and don't say we didn't warn you, little sinners.
Endlessly searching for an original
sin. Hey guys, welcome back to Lucy's Got Problems. Something touched my thigh again. This time, the stroke wasn't so light. If I didn't know there were only fish and pebbles in this river, I would have thought that someone pushed me on purpose.
Huh?
The same feeling repeated on the other side. Someone pretty strongly hit my thigh. The water around me covered in ripples. Lucy's like, it's not that bad, I can deal with it. After all I've encountered in this forest, I decided to be wiser to practice subterfuge. I'll just imagine that it's not there. If I ignore it, maybe it'll go away. Did I say that out loud? No matter. Nothing strange is happening here. Nothing at all. Probably it was not the greatest artistic performance in the world, but hey, at least I tried. Meanwhile, the creature in the water didn't appreciate my struggle. I felt more and more nudges from all sides. Well, at least I wasn't trying to... Well, at least it wasn't trying to grope me. But still, something was off. I suddenly realized that I'd been seeing the same stretch of bank for a while. I stopped moving? Meanwhile, the river surface around me was already bubbling. With a loud splash, water expulsed.
What the heck is this?
Oh, the heck it was! In mere minutes, dozens of lean fish bodies were flinching over the river.
Why do they look like dead?
Oh my god, they actually have little sensor lines. It's adorable. Most of all, they were resembling...
I'm out of here!
My peaceful journey down the river came to an abrupt end. Thankfully, the water was still shallow, so I was able to stand up. The only thing remaining was getting to the bank through all those fish!
Ah! Ooh! Where do you think you're jumping, you fish head?
Walking through the water is not easy by itself, but with these fish, this task became a next level hard. I had to push through the slippery bodies and dodge their rams. Wherever I went, the fish followed.
Hey, stop bugging me!
That fish flew right past my face. These creatures leapt so high!
Ah! Why are you all aggroed on me?
I shambled to the bank even more actively. Probably I wasn't so determined in my whole life. This forest was literally overflowing me with motivation. Finally, I reached the land and fell into the reeds.
Now I know what wrath of nature looks like. Really? What do they want from me? What's that unmotivated aggression? Is this because I'm a demon?
I was going to add something else, but suddenly several fishes soared into the air at the same time, dangerously close by. I immediately realized fighting for justice would be better continued away from the river. Besides, I still need to find some less aggressive food. I stalwartly climbed out of the reeds. The deeper I went into the forest, the more peculiar it became. The weirdest thing was the bluish glow that seemingly came out of every blade of grass.
Is this some wild magic? Never thought I would see something like this with my own eyes. In a place like this, you should be doubly cautious. You step on a wrong toad and cause a magical disaster. Well, at least I don't really have to be looking for breakfast here.
I slip my hand into one of the hidden pockets. A couple of minutes and a dozen agile moves later, and I held a chocolate chip muffin, fresh and soft right from the oven.
Mmm, the smell. Funny, I almost forgot one of my pockets leads to a bakery shelf. These mini space doors are a real miracle.
Now that the breakfast question was solved, I could walk around as much as I wanted and look around with no stress. I took a small, delightful bite of the muffin and realized my mistake too late.
No, this can't be.
My throat got tight and tears appeared in my eyes.
Not the raisins!
I quickly spit out the unfinished cupcake.
Pew, pew. Disgusting! How could I be so wrong?
Remaining cake got cast into the same shrub while I went through my dimensional pockets again. Grab, tackle, sweep, and a brand new muffin appeared in my hand.
This can't be! This one has raisins too? And this one, and this one!
More and more muffins flew into the bush.
I can't believe it! They always used to bake chocolate ones. How could they do this to me? I'll die without chocolate muffins in this sinkhole.
I fell down on my knees and was ready to cry, but suddenly, through the blurs of my tears, I noticed something strange. I even had to rub my eyes in disbelief. On a small clearing right in front of me was a door. Whoever put it here clearly knew their trade, and the door was standing upright as if supported by an invisible wall. Basically, it was just a normal door. If not for an unbelievably strong magic aura, I didn't even need Sneck to notice it.
If there's a door, it must lead somewhere. And if a door is magical, it can lead anywhere, for example, into a secret artifact storage. It makes sense to store magical artifacts behind magical doors, right? Maybe that's where the seer lives. I doubt the homeowner would be pleased if I just dropped by without an invitation. Why didn't they just add a tag or something? Now I have to decide what to do.
I do enjoy the shit out of this game. Knock politely.
I won't tempt my fate. It's easy to offend a wizard, but dodging a fireball is much harder.
I brushed muffin crumbs off my breast and knocked on the door 3 times. No answer. I knocked again, louder this time.
I'm not at home.
The voice sounded muted from behind the door, so I couldn't determine who it belonged to. Maybe it's the door itself?
If you're not home, then who's talking to me?
A voice recording. You can leave a message after the tone. Beep.
Hey, don't even try to deceive me. It doesn't even sound like a proper tone.
And you don't sound like a delivery guy from the Alchemist Workshop.
Nevertheless, I'll give you a chance. Do you have my frog maw tentacle with you? No? What about my fresh censored fish?
Censored fish night.
No, but...
Just as I thought. As soon as you place a door portal for a couple of hours, you get pestered by useless salesmen and their similarly useless goods.
Hey, I'm not a man. I'm not planning to sell anything yet. Actually, I'm here to obtain something instead. Maybe some answers at least?
Oh my. What does such a determined person as you do on... What does such a determined person as you do on the wrong side of the door?
I'm minding my manners.
Very well. You may proceed as long as you feel necessary. And then come in so that we can talk business. And is it safe? Possibly.
Well, since I had already found a mysterious door in a magical forest, I might as well take the opportunity and enter it. Certainly the voice was just scaring me. It was time to show all those forest hippies that Lucia Fur is made of. I took the doorknob and eagerly turned it.
Hmm.
Oh yes, you get Suka's voice. Or you get Raven's voice.
There was a naked lady behind the door. Or rather, not entirely naked. She was barely covered by the light silk scarf holding on a prayer and a fairy dust. When I opened the door, the light fabric danced in the wind.
I beg your pardon. I must have come at the wrong time. Or at the wrong door. I didn't know you were. I'm leaving.
Hmm. And what's the problem?
Well, you're undressed. I didn't know you were changing clothes.
Me changing clothes? The lady suddenly laughed. Darling, I always dress like this. You think this scarf is too short? I never thought succubi may be so shy. Especially when you look like that. A well-mannered person would have said your costume is full of holes. But honestly, I'm surprised how all those holes still have some costume between them.
For some reason, I felt a bit offended.
Hey, that wasn't my fault, you know.
The mysterious lady just shrugged indefinitely. Whatever. At the same moment, I felt a hot wave of magical power.
Hey, what are you doing? What was that?
A momentary charity.
I suddenly realized my costume was back in its original form. I'm sorry, did Raven suddenly show up in the game?
Thank you, I guess. Wait a minute. How do you know I'm a succubus?
Some call me the seer. Besides, you have horns, tail, and a heart-branded armband.
Well, yeah, sounds convincing.
So, what was your question? Puppies like to bark. There should be a reason you are so desperate to get in here. Make it quick. I have a ton of important magical stuff to attend to.
I don't think we should be deceiving the seer.
The thing is, I really desperately need the Orb of Fate. I'd be drawn and quartered if I returned without it. It's a very magical thingy, and you look like someone who's good at magic, so I wanted...
Nope.
No what?
It's my answer to your question, dear.
You mean you don't know where the Orb of Fate might be?
I mean, I know perfectly well where the Orb of Fate is. I have it, but you won't get it.
Why is that?
Because I'm not going to give it to you. Are these all the questions you had? Even if not, I'm off.
Listen, lady!
Seer?
Seer! I took a very flippin' long and hard trip to get here. I got lost in the cursed forest. My shoes gave me blisters. I was starving. I lost faith in my favorite bakery. You can't just kick me out empty-handed.
Oh, and why's that?
I don't know, but it's just not right. I suffered so much. It's not fair. I don't even know why I'm being refused.
I see. Now be so kind and take your foot off the doorstep, or it'll get chopped off by a magical portal.
She reached out to the handle to close the door.
Stop! You think if you are such a pompous magical being, you can just push me around? How arrogant and insensitive! Yeah, I don't have a cool, fashionable, shiny exclamation mark over my head, but I have feelings. You can't just dismiss a poor adventurer with nothing. It's totally plain heartless.
Ooh, what did you say?
I got a bad feeling about this.
I said that.
Go directly to the part where you try to insult me, describing my best traits. Okay, never mind. That was just for pleasure. What did you say about the exclamation mark?
Well, it exists. It's pretty big, red, and shiny. Levitates above your head right here. Never saw something like this.
Is that so? You know, I changed my mind. You will get the Orb of Fate.
What? Just like that?
Oh. First, you didn't like that I wasn't going to give you the Orb of Fate. Now you don't like that I am. Say, are you ever satisfied?
Me? I'm always satisfied, round the clock. Maybe except the times when I skip breakfast or dinner. Or when they wake me up too early, or when... Doesn't matter. Don't change the subject. You think I don't see through your devious plan?
Oh, and what my devious... What?
Oh,
and what my devious... Okay, no, I did read that right. You guys got that one wrong. Oh, and what's my devious plan?
I don't know, but I'm sure you have one. I feel something fishy about the whole situation.
So you're not entirely hopeless. Of course there's a catch.
And of course you won't tell me what it is.
Why not? Thing is, you're a heroine promised in legends. A heroine to save the world and us all and so on and so forth. And the Orb of Fate is your tool to world-saving trade. Oh, and also the only chance to survive.
What?
I'm also baffled, but let's not lose our heads. Heads can be useful. At least you can boil them. Have you ever tasted head stew with orange juice? It's the most refreshing thing ever.
Wait, what?
Darling, are you healthy? You're spacing out. There's no time to get sick, because we need to do a lot of stuff.
You said we?
Well, of course. I'm your mentor, after all. Nice to meet you. The seer stretched her hand out. Only now I noticed that her hands were black to the elbow, and each finger ended in a delicate claw. I identify as ten...
I swear to God I'll be able to read this in a second. I know the fact that these guys are taking the piss, and I love it. And the fact is, the best part about all of this is they're taking the piss. But I can tell you for a fact, the writer apparently got really worried he offended me with the ADHD comment, and he didn't. So, I like these guys. They want to take the piss, but they actually do care.
I identify as a ten-tailed, black-footed ferret. And sometimes it's an owl. If she says a raven, I'm going to walk away. My name is Fowl, by the way. But that's for friends only. So you keep calling me the Seer. And don't you dare misname me. Your name is Lucia Farr, or Fer, and you have a lot of middle names. And now, please shake my hand so that we can end this tiring social ritual. I obediently put my hand into the Seer's palm, and in a blink of an eye, she dragged me through the portal door. I heard a clank of the lock and the words of some spell in an incomprehensible language. Though, maybe it was just the Seer's accent. She had a strange manner of talking, well, stranger manners in general.
What's the meaning of this? Am I in detention? Am I being detained? I'm a sovereign citizen. Holy fucking Christ! Them titties! Holy shit, it's like fucking Raven and Suga had a kid. What the fuck? I don't know if I have to censor this. Hold the hell on. I want to see if she looks...
I actually want to see if she looks any different. How do you do it? Oh, you have to do it in the main menu, don't you? Well, YouTube, you know what? Have your fucking hissy fit. I don't care anymore.
You're in my home.
Home, right? The moist cave full of shining crystals was nothing I'd call home. It was shocking that someone could live in here. It was even more shocking to find such a place behind the plain-looking door, even if it was reeking of magic. On the other hand, the Seer didn't look like a plain anyone else.
You can suit yourself, just don't touch anything that doesn't sit in... You can suit yourself, just don't touch anything and don't sit anywhere. Actually, it'd be better if you froze in place.
By the way, before people go nuts with the censoring, that's a shadow on the breasts.
It's a shadow. She is fully covered. Where did I put my invisible magic anti-personnel landmines? They are experimental prototypes, my personal invention. By the way, what were we talking about?
Ahem! But if I'm not a prisoner, why did you shut the door then?
It was chilly. Besides, it's not all that safe outside. Side effects of the imminent end of the world, you know. Even if you don't know, you will soon enough be a pro in this field, I assure you.
End of the world? Crap, that's unfortunate. I just recently transferred to this world, and it's already in grave danger. Why do you think I'm the person, the promised legendary heroine, anyway?
Bitch, do you want the damn orb?
I'm the personal thing, yeah.
Well, you had arrived like the legends promised. You demanded the artifact like the legends promised. Besides, you see a secret sign above my head like the legends promised. That's enough for me.
That's all the evidence you have?
I am the seer, bitch. I can see everything.
Oh, yeah, that's true, but I mean... What if I just listened to all these legends and lied about seeing the exclamation? I mean the secret sign.
I see the truth more often than not. And if I'm wrong, you'll simply die a horrible and pointless death. I don't see a problem, so don't worry.
You don't see a problem?
Heroes often have psychological problems because of this societal pressure. All the eyes are turned to them, and the public has high expectations. Something like that. You're completely safe with me. I have no idea how you managed to survive before our meeting, so I don't expect anything serious from you. Cherish it.
Don't you say. Okay. I could use some words of encouragement.
I'm here to mentor you, not support you, and we'll find out more next time. Thank you guys for joining me for more Lucy's Got Problems. Give some love to me in the comments section and in the likes section. Don't forget to check out our Patreon. We have a Ko-fi, and if we get enough on there, we might make that, because apparently it's an alternate Patreon, so I might put the $6 a month in to make it exactly like Patreon. Check out all the other links in the descriptions. There's some really awesome stuff you guys can get. All those fantastic links. If you want to pick up this game, I suggest getting it on Steam. You can get it in a bunch of other places. Go give some love to the creators. They're on Twitter. They have their own Patreon where you can get the dirty version that I'm playing. And I'll see you guys next time. Thank you again for joining me. Bye, everyone.